One of the reasons that Final Cut is so fast is due to the background tasks feature. If you have background rendering turned on while you're editing, then that background rendering is not happening. It's not till you stop to think about something does that background rendering then take over and fill in those gaps until you start editing again, and then the background rendering turns off. In my experience, the background tasks come on a little bit too quickly with the default settings. So what I suggest you do is extend the time period a little so you don't get the lags in between it switching on and switching off. I'll show you how to make those settings and extend that time. I'm Bruce Macbryde. My goal is to improve your knowledge and to speed up your workflow in Final Cut. You'll find in the description below there are timestamps which will let you jump to different parts of this video. YouTube is a great place to learn Final Cut, but you don't always get your questions answered as they come to your mind. So save time searching through YouTube. I can help you with your Final Cut questions. Just click the link in the description below. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. So the first thing I'd like to do for you is adjust the time delay before background rendering starts. So what you need to do is to go to your preferences, and in the playback setting, you can see that background rendering is currently turned on. It can be turned off there as well. And just change the setting. Now let's change it to say 5 seconds. And that's all you need to do. From here, Final Cut takes over and looks after things for you. All you need to do from time to time, if you want to, is to turn the background rendering off when you feel you don't need it. The first of the background tasks that I'd like to talk about is the import. Now, you may not have thought about this, but when you import a file, it immediately becomes available as a thumbnail in the browser, and you can start editing immediately. The actual import of the file is happening in the background. So if I come to import here and we select the file, and the moment that I press this, you can see the file has come available and I can start adding inputs or outputs to that file, and I can bring it into the timeline or before the actual import has been completed. If you'd like to know more about the settings of the import window, click the eye above, and this will take you to one of my earlier videos that discusses the importing. So if you check on this here, this is where the background tasks are happening, and you can see the importing there. If you check on the pause, you can pause, and if you check on the X, then it stops the process. And when the process is completed, you'll see there's a little tick mark here, and if you check, there's nothing happening in the background task window. This window is a floating window, and you can move it around the screen wherever you want to. To close it, just press the red button. The next background task I'd like to talk about is you can copy events to a library, and you can move events to a library. Currently, I'm producing a video that will show you the details on how to do that. If you subscribe to my channel now, you'll be notified when that's uploaded. Don't forget to press the bell. And those tasks are happening in the background, and you will see them showing in the background window. And one of the other background tasks is the flow transition, which comes under your dissolve transitions. And if you put that at an edit point, then that smooths the process between those two clips. Optical flow is used in an interview situation where you've needed to cut some of the dialogue out, and perhaps the person's head has moved too much. I'm also producing a video on how to use the optical flow effect. The next background task that I'd like to talk to you about is rendering. When a file is rendered, it will be quicker for you to move around the timeline, and the editing process will be a lot slicker as the processor is not so stressed. And also, your exports will be quicker. And no matter what, Final Cut needs to render before it exports. So if the rendering process is happening in the background in between your edits, so when you ask it to export, then that export process will be a lot quicker because the rendering has already taken place. So if we look at this project here in the timeline, you can see these dotted lines at the top. Now those are the lines that showing you that the rendering is yet to happen in that portion of the clip. And over here on the left-hand side, where there are no dotted lines, that's saying that that portion has already been rendered. And if you remember, we have background rendering turned on, and you'll see the progress of those dotted lines. They are slowly disappearing as we look. Now let's look at the consolidation and the deletion of the render files. Now this is something you should do after your project has been completed, after it's been exported, and then when you're ready to archive. So what the consolidation does is it searches out on your hard disk for all those original files that are floating around, and it consolidates those into the library file so that then you can archive. First of all, we'll select the library. We'll go to the file menu and select Consolidate Library Media. Or you can go select the library and you can consolidate from the inspector. You can select the original media. You can also select optimized media and proxy media. Now you probably won't want the optimized or proxy media if you're archiving anyway. And I also mentioned deletion of generated files as a background task. You'd want to do this to in fact remove any optimized or proxy media projects to be archived, so they take up less space on your hard disk. Every 10 to 15 minutes after an action, Final Cut will create a backup so that you can go back to the state of play that happened earlier, either months or years later. You can access these backups from the File menu, open the library, and then Backups. And these backups are just another of those background tasks that you'll not be aware of at the time. And here you can see the most recent backup, and there are all of the previous backups there, and each of these is a separate project. And should you need to access these in the Finder, then this is the process. We need to go to the Go To menu in the Finder and go to your hard disk and then find the Users folder. You will find the Movies folder, and inside the Movies folder is the Final Cut Backups folder. And if we look at all of these, there's a separate folder for each project that we've been working with. If I select the Monique one here, we can see here that there are backups for these dates: 27th of November 2019, 16th of December 2019. And these backups are just reference files. So if you look at the size, they're fairly small, only 10 megabytes, or even the large ones are 36 megabytes. So they don't take up a lot of space on your hard disk. These are just reference files, and they refer to the original media or the optimized media that's currently on your hard disk. If those items aren't available when you open one of these backup files, then you will see that there is missing media. And what you'd need to do then is to come to Relink Files and look for original media. All of the exporting from Final Cut is also done in the background, and this gives you ability to continue editing and even editing in the actual project that's being exported. As you can see, these background functions really smooth up the process of editing in Final Cut. The background processes are happening while you're not editing, while you're thinking about something, or you're on the phone, or having lunch even. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.